You know, you zone in and...
Eventually a girl's like, oh yeah, his chances are so low.
So finally she was like, yeah, sure, oh, I'm going to get you. Yeah, but
it's like, well, are you really going to like this?
You know,
you
know,
oh,
no.
Oh,
my.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so
I think
that's
the same
thing.
You're one
little
lawyer.
Yeah, so I think that's the same
thing.
Thank you. And at this time, we have kind of installed cell phones on both sides of them, or turned them off. And please remember that during the ceremony, there is no flash photography or videos during the ceremony. Please remember to keep your beads, for that will be your entry into the reception. The couple is very excited. You have gathered here today to share this amazing time. So thank you very much. And we really appreciate it. on this joyous occasion.
We welcome all of you who have come to be participants in this marriage between Michael and Anna Grace. As dear friends and family, you have helped support their relationship from the very beginning. And by witnessing their marriage ceremony today, both Michael and Anna Grace ask for you to share in their future. Everyone, you may be seated. Throughout time and tradition, it has been the distinct honor and privilege for someone to present the bride in marriage. Who presents this bride today? From the very first days of your lives, you both set out on an amazing journey, which has led you to this very moment. And now standing here today for the purpose of fulfilling your desires to unite in marriage, we begin. Here and now, you will take your marriage vows, exchange wedding rings, and make a total commitment to each other. Marriage is a covenant, a promise made in the hearts of two people who deeply feel that their lives are and will always be shared as one. This decision to marry is the most important and sacred commitment of all life. Today, when you, Michael and Anna Grace, pledge to love and care for each other in marriage, you will create a bond that will bind you closer than any spoken or written word. Now, there are words that can help maintain this commitment that you are pledging today, and they are found in God's holy word. They're found in Genesis chapter 2, which says, "So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon man, and when he slept, he took one of his ribs and closed it up with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from man, he made into woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, 'At last, this is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his mother and father and fast to his wife.'" You'll notice that Eve was taken from the rib of Adam. She was not taken from his head that she should rule over him. She was not taken from his foot that he should walk over her. She was taken from his side, near his heart, that hand in hand together, both of you can live life. Also, in 1 Corinthians 13, it says, "Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, and always hopes and perseveres. Love never fails." And along with this love that only comes from God, there are also four essential keys that you'll need for your marriage to flourish. You'll need communication. That is to say, good communication requires practice, goodwill and communication, so make sure you practice. It also needs respect, which provides space for love to flow, so make sure you respect. Trust. It was once said the best proof of love is trust, so make sure you trust one another. And it also requires forgiveness. The one phrase that will improve your marriage the faster you learn to say it is, "Please forgive me." Now at this time, Michael and Anna Grace will participate in the lighting of the unity candle. These candles represent not only their legacy and heritage, but also their lives up until this point. They are both have been a light to this world and to many others here today as a single light. But when they use their candles today to light the middle one, then blow theirs out, this will represent their lives moving forward being as one. For one purpose, one life, and in one heart. Excuse me. Supposed to have. allow us a moment of prayer for Michael and Anna Grace. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time and this day. Thank you for this day that you have made, and we will rejoice. And we are rejoicing now that we are able to experience this amazing unity of two who become one. Father, we remember their legacies, God. We remember the generations beforehand. We also look to today and tomorrow. Please, Father, today, lead them, guide them, and protect them. In your name, amen. And now for the exchanging of vows. Michael and Anna Grace, as you prepare to pledge your vows to one another, let me remind you that no other vows are more sacred, no words more tender than those you are about to assume. May these vows only be broken by death, and may both of you live a very long and happy life together. As a symbol of your union, now with your hands joined, look into the eyes that you want that you love. Please repeat after me. Michael, repeat after me. Today, Anna Grace.
Today, Anna Grace.
I join my life to yours.
I join my life to yours.
Not only as your husband.
Not only as your husband.
But as your friend.
But as your friend.
Your lover.
Your lover.
And your confidant.
And your confidant.
I promise to be there.
I promise to be there.
When you need me.
When you need me.
To fill our days with love.
To fill our days with love.
To comfort you.
To comfort you.
Encourage you.
Encourage you.
To help you reach your goals.
To help you reach your goals.
And to love you.
And to love you.
With all of my heart.
With all of my heart.
Anna Grace, please repeat after me. Today, Michael.
Today, Michael.
I join my life to yours.
I join my life to yours.
Not only as your wife.
Not only as your wife.
But as your friend.
But as your friend.
Your lover.
Your lover.
And your confidant.
And your confidant.
I promise to be there.
I promise to be there.
When you need me.
When you need me.
To fill our days with love.
To fill our days with love.
To comfort you.
To comfort you.
Encourage you.
Encourage you.
To help you reach your goals.
To help you reach your goals.
And to love you.
With all of my heart.
And now for the rings. The rings, please. I told you it was good. I told you it was gonna be good. Started breathing hard. Michael and Anna Grace, when you place your rings on each other's fingers today, your rings will become an ever-present symbol of your mutual love and vows that you have made today on your wedding day. So, Michael, please place the ring on your bride's finger, hold it in place, and repeat after me. Anna Grace.
Anna Grace.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Anna Grace, please place the ring on your groom's finger. Hold it in place and repeat after me. Michael.
Michael.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Now at this time, we'll take a moment to bless your hands. So with your hands joined, the blessing of the hands is to you to remind each other that throughout life, you will need to hold each other always. Michael and Anna Grace, these are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you. These are being held by yours on this, your wedding day, as you promise to love each other for the rest of your lives. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future, as you share your innermost secrets and dreams together. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you throughout the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief threatens to overwhelm you. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it the most. These are the very hands that will countless of times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you hold your family together as one. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, will still be giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a simple touch. Allow us to pray to bless the hands. God, our Father, please bless these hands before you on this day. May they always be held by one another. Keep them tender and gentle as they nourish each other. Help these hands to continue building a relationship founded in your love and grace. May Michael and Anna Grace see their four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. We ask this in your name. Amen. And now, as you, Michael and Anna Grace, have pledged your vows and have consented to wed each other, have consecrated this celebration with the giving and accepting of wedding rings. By the virtue of the authority vested in me under the laws of our beautiful state of Louisiana, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Michael, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, may you please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise at this time? As I present to you for the very first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Michael Nemore. She forgot her flowers. Not yet. And
ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, the couple has asked if we could join them for a second line dance. So on your way down, please make sure during the cocktail hour you find a napkin, because they would like for everyone to please celebrate outside with a second line dance. Please be reminded that you will need your beads to enter the reception. Thank you very much. Please enjoy. Oh, beautiful, man. And as I started getting wider, man, you danced. Great job. Beautiful job. Mike was just like, they got it. So you told him. Oh, thank you, brother. I appreciate it. Thank you. That'll be great. Thank you so much. There you go. There you go.
cocktail hour, but I'm not sure. Brooke left with them. She's supposed to be directing everyone to the cocktail hour. During the cocktail hour, they will grab everybody, handkerchiefs, and then we'll go to the second line. They went upstairs, but I'm waiting for Brooke to text me back. Where does everyone go for the cocktail hour? Question mark. I'm finding out right now. She didn't give clear directions, so. I didn't know either. She didn't tell me either. Does it? Does it? They are not, and everyone seems confused, period. I'll talk to them. Excuse me. Sorry about you. You're good, my friend. It's the Royal Room. They're supposed to be directing, so let me get their staff. Their staff is supposed to be directing everyone. The Royal Room this way? Okay, great. Left at the elevator? Okay, great. We had nobody upstairs bringing them down. I'll get them down for you. It's downstairs to the left. Downstairs, I'll get everybody there. Downstairs to the left. Yeah, make an announcement. Would everyone please join him for the cocktail hour downstairs? Would everyone please join everyone for the cocktail hour downstairs? Thank you so much. Could everyone please join downstairs for the cocktail hour? Downstairs to your left. How you doing? How y'all doing? Absolutely, my friend, absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. They are all...